ಅಣ್ಣ ಒಂದು ಚೂರು ಸೈಡು
ಅಣ್ಣ
ಮೇಡಮ್
ಜೀವನ
ಅಣ್ಣ ಅಳ್ಳಿ ಬಿಡೋಣ ವಿ ಸಿ ಸರ್ ಮುಂದೆ ಬನ್ನಿ ಸರ್ ವಿ ಸಿ ಸರ್ ಮುಂದೆ ಬನ್ನಿ ಸರ್
ಇಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗೋಣ ಹಂಗೆ ಒಂಚೂರು ಅಣ್ಣ ಒಂಚೂರು ಚೂರು ಸೈಡು ಅಣ್ಣ ಅದ್ ಕಾಣಲ್ಲ ಒಂಚೂರು
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ರೆಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಸರ್ ಇದು ಓಕೆ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಬಂದು ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಬಂದು ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ ಸೀಸನಲ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ತೌಸಂಡ್ 395 ಅಂದ್ರೆ 25% ಭಾರತದಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋ ಆನೆಗಳು ನಮ್ಮ ರಾಜ್ಯದಲ್ಲಿ
ಕಂಡ್ರೆ ಸರ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹಂಗೆ ಪಾಸ್ ಆಗಲಿ
ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹಿಂದೆ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಲಾಂಗ್
ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ನೀವು ಆ ಕಡೆ
ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟೆ ಇವುಗಳಿಗೆ ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಒಳಗೆ
ಸೈಡಿಗೆ ಬರ್ಬೇಕು ಸರ್
ಮಾಡೋಣ ಒಂಚೂರು ಸೈಡು ಸರ್ ಎದುರುಗಡೆ ನಾನೇ
On behalf of the Forest Department, it is a profound privilege to extend a heartfelt welcome to you, sir. The Honorable Chief Minister comes from the 3-4 major contributions of the Honorable Chief Minister to the Forest Department, apart from being so large-hearted in giving us budgetary allotment to you, sir. You were part of the Bandipur Charter when we signed the first interstate charter. Sir was responsible, our Forest Minister, Kerala Forest Minister is over here. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Maroj Rajan, for extending a very standing and addressing the drivers of human-elephant conflict. Please put your hands together, ladies and gentlemen. It's a very important moment. 21 international participants, 33 exhibitors, 25 research papers, 13 best practice papers, and cross-sectoral collaboration and community participation. Achieve Kannada Deepa, even though Prabhivada and Kela Hari Kandige, Deepa Kannada Deepa is back. International Conference on Human Elephant Conflict Management 2024. And remember, today is the World Elephant Day, August 12, 2024. True to be being a friend of the environment, the Karnataka Forest Department now, the Honorable Chief Minister will water the plan, signaling that the Karnataka government has always been environment friendly. The watering of the plan signifies the environment friendly. International Conference on Human Elephant Conflict Management, ladies and gentlemen, inaugurated by the Honorable Chief Minister of Karnataka, Shri Siddharamaiah, in the presence of all the dignitaries, sends a message that Karnataka is in the forefront of this all-important environment-oriented conflict management, and the Honorable Chief Minister now leading from the front. ತಂದ್ರೆಯು ಗೌರವವನ್ನು ಸೂಚಿಸಬೇಕಾಗಿ ವಿನಂತಿ ಬಾಯ್ ಫೆಲಿಸಿಟೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಆನರಬಲ್ ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್. The Additional Chief Secretary, Forest Ecology and Environment, Government of Karnataka, Shri Manjunath.
Ellarige namaskara. Very good morning to everyone. Give my greetings on the World Elephant Day. Elephant Day, World Elephant Day started since 2012 with an objective of preserving.
Before we do certain things, we should follow, or else we will lead to big problems. Then we say, Sadhu Mirandar Kaadu Ullar. It means that
there are inhibiting this world. After seeing his plight, Karnataka is the adjoining landscape.
The testament to the fact that the conference is a truly collaborative effort. Various handbooks and research papers for India. The research paper presentation.
Hey.
At the same time, they also have the best practices compendium, which is also going to be released. They will also have the Karnataka Elephant Population Estimation 2024, which is being released. Please put your hands together later on. We also have the poster competition and the exhibition. Video audio bit. Exhibition release and the poster competition, which is going to be released now. The photo gallery, which gives us a bird's eye view of the international human wildlife conflict management. So let's give a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. It is a record created by Karnataka that so many events are happening in one shot in one moment. Ecology and conservation education community. We have authored several books and over 200 scientific papers, making significant contributions to science and ecology. Ladies and gentlemen, he has played a pivotal role in changing conservation policies in India. He is part of the committee that designed the new green biosphere. So let's give a round of applause and congratulate Dr. Rama Sundar. Posthumous award and receive the award on behalf of Dr. A.J.T. Johnson. He is a pioneering Indian wildlife biologist and conservation expert for his significant contributions. He played a crucial role in the study and conservation of wildlife. His legacy is marked by his profound impact on both the scientific and conservation community at large. Concluding it, the Karnataka Forest Department has made significant contributions to wildlife conservation, notably received the first Green Oscar Award for the Asian subcontinent. Ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Dr. Sidiyappa. And now another award is posthumous. Shri Karthik, Elephant Task Force Staff, and the schooling also take place in Gaudarali, or a Parvagi, or a Thai, for the Elephant and Drive-By Parvagi, and the Drive-By, he tragically lost his life, and now he's being awarded posthumously. Purposely, Rishesh Bhagi, he is an elephant mount at Malaysia, and he serves the world by his wife. He served in various capacities and served after being promoted to Mahon. Dhanyavaad, Sanapa. And both of the DCP government for 20 years in Kumara Elephant Camp participated in the 8th Dasara procession for Gopi Elephant career and now Sanatya Elephant. Bali Elephant and Murukarayu, Muvattai Elephant Actor of the Pakistan Act, Rajan. Rajan Avrige, Samastha.
I request the Honorable CM to kindly receive the felicitation from Tamil Nadu. Honorable DCM, Shri DK Shivkumar will now receive the felicitation. Honorable Forest Minister Shri Ishwar B. Khandre after this.
ನಮಸ್ಕಾರಗಳು. ಶ್ರೀ ಡಿ ಕೆ ಶಿವಕುಮಾರ್, ಆನರಬಲ್ ಡೆಪ್ಟಿ ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಶ್ರೀ ಈಶ್ವರ್ ಖಂಡ್ರೆ, ಆನರಬಲ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಶ್ರೀ ಶಶೀಂದ್ರನ್, ಆನರಬಲ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕೇರಳ, ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಮತಿ ವೇಂದನ್, ಆನರಬಲ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ತಮಿಳ್ನಾಡು, ಮಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಬೈದ್ಯನಾಥನ್, ಆನರಬಲ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಜಾರ್ಖಂಡ್, ಶ್ರೀ ಪೊನ್ನಣ್ಣ, ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಲೆಜಿಸ್ಲೇಟಿವ್ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಲೀಗಲ್ ಅಡ್ವೈಸರ್ ಟು ಚೀಫ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್, ಶ್ರೀ ಮಂಜುನಾಥ್ ಪ್ರಸಾದ್, ಅಡಿಷನಲ್ ಚೀಫ್ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟರಿ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಅದರ್ ಡಿಗ್ನಿಟರೀಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಡಯಾಸ್, ಡಿಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ವಿಶ್ಡ್ ಡೆಲಿಗೇಟ್ಸ್, ಲೇಡೀಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಜೆಂಟಲ್ಮನ್, ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ಡೆಡಿಕೇಟೆಡ್ ಕನ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನಿಸ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವೈಡ್ ಅಟ್ ದಿ ಔಟ್ಸೆಟ್, ಐ ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟೆಂಡ್ ಮೈ ವಾರ್ಮ್ ಗ್ರೀಟಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ ಡೇ 2024 ಟು ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಇಯರ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಐ ಫರ್ಗಾಟ್ ದಿ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಮೀಡಿಯಾ. ಐ ಹಾರ್ಟಿಲಿ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಈಚ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಅಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಿವೋಟಲ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕಾನ್ಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ದಿ ಥೀಮ್ ಆಫ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ ಡೇ 2024 ಹೈಲೈಟ್ಸ್ ದಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಿಸರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎನ್ಶೂರ್ ದಿ ಸರ್ವೈವಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಐ ವುಡ್ ಆ್ಯಡ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ದಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಸರ್ವಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾಬಿಟ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ರಿಡ್ಯೂಸಸ್ ದಿ ಮ್ಯಾನ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ವಿಟ್ನೆಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಟ್ ಎನ್ ಅಲಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ಲಿ ಹೈ ರೇಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾದರಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ದ್ಯಾನ್ ಎ ಕಾನ್ಫರೆನ್ಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಟಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ಲಾಟ್ಫಾರಮ್ ವೇರ್ ವಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಚೇಂಜ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್, ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೋರ್ ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಕೊಲಾಬರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರೆಸಿಂಗ್ ಇಶ್ಯೂ ಆಫ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್, ಎ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಿಫಿಕೆಂಟ್ ಇಕಲಾಜಿಕಲ್, ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್. ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕೋ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಥೌಸಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಯರ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಬೌಂಡ್ರೀಸ್, ಡೆವಲಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವಿಟೀಸ್, ದಿ ಕ್ಲೈಮೇಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ನ್ಯಾಚುರಲ್ ರಿಸೋರ್ಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಚೇಂಜಿಂಗ್, ಪುಟಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರೆಷರ್ ಆನ್ ಅಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆಮ್. Meanwhile, elephants increasingly find their home ranges fragmented by new villages, farms, cities, highways, or industrial growth such as mining. Barriers like fences and train tracks force them to travel longer distances and risk injury. The land where they once foraged is now home to human agriculture, and accessing watering holes increases their contact with villagers. As climate changes, raises temperatures and changes rainfall patterns, resources become even more scarce and elephants get pushed into new areas, including communal lands. Humans face their own challenges as they must move deeper into elephant territory to collect water or firewood. The competition becomes fierce and life-threatening for people and wildlife. India proudly houses the largest population of Asiatic elephants globally, with about 30,000 elephants as per the 2017 census. Karnataka is the state with the highest elephant population, with 6,395 elephants, which makes approximately 25% of the nation's total elephant population. The state is also home to the second highest population of tigers, at 563 tigers, as given by the All India Tiger Formation Estimation 2022. The large number of large mammals and top predators indicate a healthy population of herbivores and other forest resources. This status of rich forest wealth can be attributed to the conservation activities undertaken by the Forest Department over the past few decades. Karnataka is privileged to have two major elephant reserves, the Mysore Elephant Reserve and the Dandeli Elephant Reserve. Together, these reserves cover an area of over 10,000 square kilometers and play a crucial role in conserving our elephant populations and their habitats. However, an increase in human-wildlife conflict has been observed in recent years due to developmental resources and fragmentation of forest areas. With Karnataka's significant elephant population comes the inevitable challenge of human-elephant conflict. In the last 10 years, the state reported over 2,500 incidents of human-elephant conflicts, resulting in over 350 human fatalities and substantial crop losses. This issue is not unique in our state, but it is shared by almost all regions with substantial elephant populations. Today's discussions will focus on how we can address these conflicts effectively and substantially and sustainably. Recognizing the severity of this issue, Karnataka has allocated a dedicated budget head specifically for addressing human-animal conflicts. Annually, over 150 rupees crores are directed toward mitigating human-elephant conflicts. These funds support various initiatives, including installing physical barriers such as over 300 kilometers of railway barricades, solar fencing spanning over 800 kilometers, solar tentacle fencing and elephant-proof trenches, etc. The rail barricading project was initiated in Karnataka, and it is the only state that has been implementing it since 2015 and 16. The rail barricade project is substantially increased the income of the farmers who cultivate on the periphery of the forests. The farmers of Karnataka have always been conservation oriented, whether it is for forests or wildlife. They have set a very good example, coexistence with the wild animals. Despite the conflicts, they have shown immense tolerance. I salute them and term them as true conservationists of the wildlife. Our government is committed to empowering farmers by providing resources and subsidies to erect solar fencing. These subsidized efforts have protected more than 50,000 acres of farmland, helping to safeguard livelihoods and promote coexistence between humans and wildlife. Our government envisions a future with human-elephant conflicts we are dedicated to enhancing our efforts, whether through increased financial allocations, technological innovations, or community engagement. The Karnataka Forest Department is well prepared with both the necessary manpower and the latest technological tools in mitigate conflicts swiftly and effectively. We have established 8 specialized elephant task forces, each led by officers of the Deputy Conservation of Forest rank, strategically positioned across the major conflict zones. To tackle the increased human elephant conflict, Karnataka has established 9 elephant task force teams. These task force are supported by control rooms that provide prompt response to public and farmer concerns, protect communities from elephant encounters, and facilitate the safe return of elephants to their natural habitats. These task forces have responded to over 1,200 conflict incidents in the past year alone, successfully driving elephants back to safer habitats. The Karnataka Aranya Samarasya project aims to establish 0 human animal conflict zones in targeted forest areas of Karnataka. This comprehensive plan involves strategies for water security, habitat improvement, and active community participation. Habitat improvement activities to minimize the straying of wild animals into human landscapes. The following habitat development works are carried out: grassland development, bamboo generation, and the creation of water holes and solar water pump facilities. Collaborative efforts have been instrumental with the Karnataka Forest Department, Rural Development and Panchayat Raj Department, and local communities. This international conference presents an invaluable opportunity to learn from one another, explore innovative scientific solutions, and discuss sustainable approaches to fostering coexistence between humans and elephants. I am confident that the distinguished delegates present here will contribute valuable insights and recommendations to pave the way for harmonious coexistence between humans and elephants. Together, we can ensure our people and wildlife safety, well-being, and prosperity. ಇವತ್ತು ನೀವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ತೆಲಂಗಾಣ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಕೊಂಡಾ ಸುರೇಖ ಐ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ You are late. Why? Okay. I welcome Srimati Konda Surekha, Honorable Minister for Forest, State of Telangana. ನೀವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ರೈತರು ಮತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ನವರು ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕೂಡ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿದ್ದೀರಿ. ಆನೆಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಮಾನವ ಈ ಸಂಘರ್ಷ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಇದನ್ನು ತಡೆಗಟ್ಟಬೇಕಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಭಾಳ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಅವಶ್ಯ. ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನು 0 ಕಾನ್ಫ್ಲಿಕ್ಟ್ಗೆ ತಗೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ನಮ್ಮ ಉದ್ದೇಶ. ಅದಕ್ಕಾಗಿ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಅನೇಕ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಗಳನ್ನು ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ನಾವು ಫಾರೆಸ್ಟ್ನಲ್ಲಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಆನೆಗಳು ಊರೊಳಗಡೆ ಬರಬಾರ್ದು ಮತ್ತು ರೈತರು ಬೆಳೆದಂಥ ಬೆಳೆಗಳನ್ನು ನಾಶ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದು ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ನಮ್ಮ ಉದ್ದೇಶ. ಅದನ್ನು ತಡೆಗಟ್ಟಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಮಾತುಗಳನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಈ ಅಂತಾರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಕಾನ್ಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಏನು ಇವತ್ತು ನಡೀತಾ ಇದೆ, ಇವತ್ತು ಇಡೀ ದಿನ ನಡೀತದೆ, ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಉತ್ತಮವಾದಂಥ ಸಲಹೆಗಳು ಹೊರಬರಲಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಆಶಿಸಿ ನಿಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿ ನನ್ನ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಮುಗಿಸ್ತೇನೆ. ಜೈ ಹಿಂದ್. Thank you.